too fucked. Tell me if it breaks, what would you decide? Hoping one day I'll see you through. When it breaks, if it breaks, we will see. I swear every time it breaks, I'll reach and pull us closer.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to this review of the Sol Notes Dioko, which is a partnership with 7Hz and Crinacle. This is the case, if anybody was curious. It's really big. It's definitely not something meant for your pocket. It was interesting. It kind of like threw me aback when I saw it. Tips. Because nobody makes a case this large, like ever. Let alone for like a $100 IEM. It just seems like this really serious thing that I would carry more than one thing in. But if you see the interior, it's clearly meant for just the wires at the bottom and the earbuds on the top. I don't know if how well you can see that, but there it is. The Dioko also has an interesting look. It's very kind of like an oval shape, and it's got this like purple thing going. You saw from the screenshots in the track demo, and you can look up images online, but it is quite a look. But that's enough about the accessories and packaging. I usually don't talk about that much anyway. Let's talk about sound. Straight off the bat, I'm going to tell you, spoiler alert, kind of my impression throughout the video, although I'll go into specifics for each track as they come. The Dioko, to me, overall, sounds like a very strong $100 IEM that anyone should consider as a top contender if that's your budget. Do I think it is better than the $200 Timeless? No, I do not. And I'm gonna spend the rest of the video trying to share my reasons why. Do I think it's better than the S12, which a lot of people have been looking at right now as a competitor? That one is going to be up to personal taste, but I would gravitate towards the S12, a solid grade above the Dioko. Again, reasons will be shared later. After each track. And lastly, you know, I could mention the OH10, which is another one of my favorites. I like that more. Basically, everything in this video I'm going to tell you I like more, with few exceptions. The Dioko is just, As balanced and nice as it sounds and as airy and clear, there are tracks where it's a little too forward on the upper end, and I just, it's not like it's fatiguing like the Kato. It's not as excited about those moments that could fatigue you. It's not shouty like to the nth degree, but it's just enough of that hard consonant sound in your face that you notice it maybe more than you'd want to. It's not a casual listen in those areas, and nor is it worth the price it pays for the excitement it gets out of that elevation in the upper end. It, when it comes along with it, when it highlights those consonants that harshly, it's, I wouldn't say it's annoying, but it is a little bit distracting from just enjoying the music. Let's keep listening to some more tracks. On the next one, we're gonna listen for drums and vocals. Maybe some guitar in there, but mostly that.
I want to break free.
Okay, I think my impressions of the Dioko being a little harsher might start to be coming through as we listen to more. Particularly if you go to the S12. If you focused on that switch between the Dioko and the S12, you can suddenly hear how the S12, even as excited and treble forward as some people think the S12 can be, compared to that, the Dioko is more. The S12 actually dials it down relatively and almost becomes, by comparison, it sounds like a more balanced set, which is an odd thing to say about the S12. It's usually more exciting. It's interesting. It's so relative like that. You know, have you ever bought something at home for your collection or whatever, if you have a collection at home, and then you try something and it's a certain impression, but then if you try a different set, like a third set, and then go back and forth there, you have a different impression? You know, that's what's happening here. The S12 in my previous video popped with excitement and forwardness. It sounded suddenly open compared to other gear. And now the Dioko sounds like it's opening up compared to the S12. But here's the thing. I prefer how the S12 handles it, because the Dioko, as open as it's trying to be, maybe is too much. It's a little too edgy. The S12 dials it down, softens the edges in a nice, not too much, but in a nice way. And then what was interesting was going from the S12 to the Timeless. The Timeless, which is a sibling of the Dioko, it's from 7 Hertz, probably similar engineering principles. And in some tracks, the Timeless and the Dioko can actually sound very similar. But going from the S12 to the Timeless, I didn't get that harshness I got as I did with the Dioko. The Timeless was like that excitement and openness and resolution of the Dioko, but without the harshness. It really kind of starts to build a case, to me anyway, to my ears, that the Timeless is kind of not entirely a linear upgrade, but kind of a straight upgrade to the Dioko, which would make sense because they're both from the same company. The Timeless is $200, the Dioko is $100, and it does sound like an upgrade. It does sound like you're paying more for a better version of the same taste, of the same style, or similar enough style. So I just thought that was interesting. Not what I expected. I thought the Dioko, before I even put them in my ears for the first time, I thought because Crinacle was collaborating on it, I thought it was going to be maybe a more different sound from the company, but it really wasn't that wildly different. So that's a good thing and a bad thing. It's a bad thing if you think that it could have been a companion to your existing Timeless, if you have a Timeless. It's not really a good companion, in my opinion. It's just kind of a downgrade. But it's a good thing if you're on a budget and you want to get the Timeless. Now you have a cheaper half-priced option that's comfortably fit, sounds pretty good, and saves you some money. That is a way to look at it. Personally, that's not me. I would save and get the Timeless. Okay, that all being said, let's go to the next track. We're going to be listening to electronic and really kind of focusing on the bass and anything that would pop up as sounding harsh. I want you to see if you can hear any harshness coming from the Dioko in this other genre. And let's also dabble a little bit with some other gear that might give us a wider reference point for how the Dioko might sound for you and your collection. Okay? Okay, now maybe you heard that kind of fatiguing, or maybe fatiguing is too strong. Maybe you heard that sibilant somewhat quality of the Dioko on that track, or maybe you haven't yet. That there is a track coming up next from OAR that, for at least me in real life, in my ears, the Dioko sounds way too boldly sibilant. Like every consonant just stands out in my. You're gonna find out, hopefully. I know everybody's speakers at home are different. So anyway, same impression as before. I threw in the messed just to see what people thought. I thought it was very interesting that on this very kind of synthetic master of like a digital, you know, electronic track, that high level of granular detail that electronic presents was very comparably perceived on both 7 Hz models, the Timeless and Dioko, as well as the Mest. The Mest didn't blow them out of the water completely and utterly. You know, it really shows the point in which diminishing returns can really be significant. And don't get me wrong, the Mest is my favorite, and I still think listening to this, the Mest does edge them out, but does it edge them out at 8 to 10 times the cost or whatever? No, not for most people. But, you know, if you appreciate small differences enough to pay for it, the truth is in the eye of the beholder. It really is so subjective. You know, what somebody is willing to spend extra on to get that little bit of joy every time they sit down to listen to their music, who's to judge them for that, honestly? But I will say my assessment so far is basically, you know, if you want to get the Mest, get the Timeless instead if you're not willing to spend that much more money for that little jump. Which is very interesting to finally demonstrate with these demos. I don't know what it was, but I finally was able to crack how to make the Timeless work in my recording rig. I'm actually pleasantly surprised by how well it's been going. And the Timeless, I don't know if people have been following my channel for too long, but the Timeless usually records very poorly in my rig. So this is a nice turn of events. And then it showed up really nicely against something like the Mest. Now, let's listen to some more. Let's listen to, what was it coming up next? OAR, Around the World or whatever. Heard the World, around whatever the track name is. And this one is really where the vocalist's consonants, those hards, letter sounds, S's, N's, whatever, T's, whatever things that really stand out with those consonants, or basically anything that's not a vowel. It doesn't even have to be like a hard consonant. Anything that's not a vowel, you're gonna hear it. The Dioko really does stand out in a bad way here, in my opinion. Does it have very sharp sounding detail? Sure, but it's at a cost. Okay, it's at a cost. And the Timeless handles it smoothly. I'm also gonna throw in a couple others. Let's listen to the Obsidian, the OH-10 rather, and the T3 Plus for anybody who has those sets at home and want to know where those sets compare to the Dioko.
I just heard the world is breaking down into bits again. Tell me, what am I to do? And you just want me to stay here. So I'm just gonna stay here. Home, the last resort. Build a castle with an iron door. Lock the window, pull the shades. The hazed out sun won't help anyway. If the world is crumbling down, I don't wanna be alone. No, locked up in this place. I heard the world up late night. Courageous today. If the world was crumbling down,
Okay, so big takeaways here that might be unique from what's already been said. The unique melody mist really, I thought, shows here how, even though it's similar to the Timeless and the Dioko in that upper end emphasis, I think it shows how to handle it right. It's the kind of the masterclass, the real polished example of how to present treble without being fatiguing or harsh, sibilant, whatever. The Timeless was like the next level down from the mist, and not bad at all for doing it. And then the Dioko was a little further down, kind of hit pretty hard here, I thought, for how harsh this track came off on it. Yes, do the cymbals and the drums sound crisp and clear? Sure. But it's too much on the Dioko. It's too much. And the Timeless was not quite too much, but like enough that you would notice it as a little overstaying its welcome. I imagine if you were listening to these tracks long enough, and depending on your genre of choice, or masters of choice, you might have a very unpleasant time listening to the Timeless. Even though it's, I think, more polished than the Dioko, the Timeless can still be overstaying its welcome if your tracks are just repetitively like this one in the way that they're mastered. Mileage will vary here. The Obsidian to me was much more mellowed out, maybe too much. You know, I could definitely see not being excited enough by the Obsidian or OH-10 when I have the Timeless next to me instead to listen to. But I think there's a role there as a kind of companion in your collection for the OH-10. If you're really considering the Timeless right now, it's not a terrible thing to get the OH-10 as well if you can afford it, because they are so different in their style. The OH-10 is warm and easy to listen to, while also being authoritative with its bass presence, while the Timeless is more crystal clear, airy, fast, separated in detail, but can play a little too much on that detail at times. So they're a good companion pair. And the T3 Plus, I thought that was very interesting to bring in, because to me, in the way that the Timeless sounds like a straight upgrade to the Dioko, the OH-10 sounds like a straight upgrade to me over the T3 Plus. It's like a bigger sibling of the T3 Plus. And in both examples, the Timeless Dioko, the OH-10 and T3 Plus, those big brothers are about double the price of their downgraded siblings, which is interesting. So I would definitely, you could even say, if you're on a budget, Dioko and T3 Plus for your companions in a collection. But if you want to spend a little bit more while not breaking the bank over something like the Mest, the Timeless and the OH-10 are great companions. And the S12 is an interesting one, because that one's sort of in between the Timeless and the OH-10, and in a similar class of enjoyment. So you could ultimately, I guess what I'm saying is, your three IEM collection for any kind of mood could be, well, not any kind of mood, that's exaggerating, but you know what I mean. The Timeless for the crystal clear upper end, the S12 for a more balanced everyday listening kind of experience, although not neutral, and the OH-10 for a bassy, authoritative, warmer, easier to listen to set. Hey, if you want to throw a neutral set in there, like a Blessing 2, even though personally I find neutral boring, or an etymotic, then go for it. But yeah, that's where I stand. And if you're really willing to break the bank, go for the Mest, because it really is just an uber Timeless. Okay, next track is... Da-da-da-da. Okay, the next track is male vocals, mainly, with some nice drumming. Very similar to Queen, I guess, in the composition that way, but it's a different master, and I think we should do our due diligence to explore other masters, other kind of tracks along those lines. Do we reaffirm what we've been hearing, or do we get anything new? Let's find out. ¶¶
saw hell to say, hey boy, you better bring a check around to the sad, sad truth, the dirty Lord down. Taught her how to talk like that. Give her that big idea. Nothing you can't handle, nothing you ain't got. Put your money on the table and drive it off the lot. Turn on that old love light, turn a maybe to a yes. Same old schoolboy game got you into this mess. Hey, son, better get on back to town. Face the sad old truth, the dirty Lord down. Put those ideas in your head. So bad, got to be so cold. This dog eat dog existence surely getting old. Got to have a Jones for this, Jones for that. This running with the Joneses, boy, just ain't where it's at. You're gonna come back around to the sad, sad truth, the dirty Lord down. Got you thinking like that, boy.
All right, I'm not gonna say too much more here because I don't think that track really emphasized anything quite unique. You know, whether you're listening to the cymbal hits on that track or anything in the upper end, really, or anything that has harmonics in the upper end, really just highlights what's been said about the Dioko. It's just it highlights the upper end too much. It's too in your face. I wouldn't go as far as to say it's fatiguing, like other gear can be, that's like really poorly tuned stuff out there can be, but it's not exactly the most pleasant thing ever. Now, I think this is really going to be each person's personal preference. If you liked how crystal clear and forward those treble regions were in those tracks for the Dioko, then you'll love it. Because it does portray, it does give you this overall impression like it's a very open sound, a very exciting sound, while still having a good amount of low end and mids. So, you know, it's a good IEM. It sounds like it's good quality. But it's just not my taste exactly. I would give it like an A minus maybe, while the Timeless still ranks at an S for me. Okay. I'm going to finish just by saying, before the last track is demoed for you to end to close out the video, I just want to, this is a very weird request, but if you're listening this long, you might appreciate my intentions here or not. I don't know. Call me a shill. I don't know what to say about it, but I'm going to include in the links in the video, in the description, for affiliate links to websites. Now, these are not specific product links, okay? But these are links to the sites at large. So if, let's say, you are a fan of Linsol as your main storefront, then if you click on the link below to go to Linsol, anything you find on the website that you want to buy for yourself, I will get whatever 2 to 5% commission off of whatever you choose to buy. It may not be anything that I've even reviewed before, but if you use those links, even bookmark them for your future reference. If you're not in the market today to buy something, bookmark my affiliate links and use them in the future when you go shopping. If you want to support me in some way and you don't want to pay for Patreon each month, or what have you, There's no other source of income here. I have copyrighted music on my videos, so I don't get any ad money. I don't have any existing sponsorships. I burned some bridges a while ago, so that's not happening. And so really, the only source of income I have from the channel is Patreon support and affiliate links. So whatever support is much appreciated. If nothing else, like, subscribe, leave comments. Let's make a lively discussion out of all this. I'll see you next time. Thank you for listening.
I learned the truth at 17. Their love was meant for beauty queens and high school girls with clear-skinned smiles who married young and then retired. The Valentines I never knew, the Friday night charades of youth were spent on one more beautiful. At 17 I learned the truth. And those of us with ravaged faces, lacking in the social graces, desperately on the phone, who called to say, come dance with me, and murmured vague obscenities. It isn't all it seems. It's 17. A brown-eyed girl in hand-me-downs, whose name I never could pronounce, said, pity please the ones who serve. They only get what they deserve. In the rich relation, hometown queen marries into what she needs with a guarantee of company and haven for the elderly. Received at 17. To those of us who knew the pain of Valentines that never came, and those whose names were never called when choosing sides for basketball, it was long ago and far away. The world was younger than today, and dreams were all they gave for free to ugly duckling girls like me. We all play the game when we dare to cheat ourselves at solitaire, inventing lovers on repenting other lives unknown. They call and say, come dance with me, murmur vague obscenities at ugly girls like me at 17.